Welcome to Let's Talk Brock.
Okay, welcome to this episode of the Let's Talk Brock podcast. Today we are joined by Abby, a fourth year concurrent education student from Sarnia. Thanks for joining us today, Abby.
Thanks for having me.
We are so excited to hear a little bit about your Brock story. So we're going to hop right into the questions. What made you choose Brock and how did you decide on concurrent education?
Yeah, definitely. So I chose Brock because I loved the region of Niagara. I thought that the university was in a very beautiful location close to Niagara Falls and Niagara on the Lake and St. Catharines. The downtown area is beautiful in itself as well. So I really liked the location of the university. Another reason I chose Brock is because it has, it's a mid-sized campus, so it wasn't too big. Like Tricia had said, I am from Sarnia, so my high school wasn't huge, so I liked the idea of the university not being too small, but not too big. I mean, it really had a community feel when I went there, because it is at the top of the Niagara Escarpment, secluded a little bit from the city center, so I really liked that atmosphere and the safety that the campus brought to me. So that was kind of the reason I chose Brock in that sense. Another reason I chose Brock was because of the concurrent education program. So when I was growing up, I obviously had this dream of wanting to be a teacher. And then in high school, talking to my guidance counselors, we kind of discussed a little bit about what a teacher needs to do in order to get to where they want to be. So we looked in the concurrent education program at a few different universities. And so I actually went to the Ontario University Fair in grade 12, and I was talking to some of the representatives at the Brock booth for the concurrent education program. And I really liked the idea of all of the experiential learning opportunities that I got at Brock. So that is a reason I ended up at Brock and in the concurrent education program here.
That's super cool. And I know you've also had the opportunity to work at those events. So it's kind of like you've done a 360 and being able to give back to Brock in that way. That's awesome. So what grade level and teachable are you in right now? How did you choose that?
Yeah, so I'm in the primary junior stream. So kindergarten to grade six. And so in kindergarten to grade six, you don't technically have a teachable. So I'm taking child and youth studies courses. But in particular, I have taken quite a few of my elective credits in the history stream so that I'm able to get an elective credit of history as well.
That's very cool. Nice. So what does a typical week look for you as a Brock student? If you're on campus and online, give me both. What does it look like?
Yeah, for sure. So a typical full-time student is in about five courses in a semester. So each course, there's about 2 or 3 hours of content for each course. So if we were in person, I'd be sitting in a two-hour lecture five times a week and then have a subsequent seminar later in the week that runs for about an hour. So you're looking at about 12 to 15 hours of like in-class time. And I found that similar in the virtual world with professors doing their Teams calls or recording any of their lectures, they typically run about the same duration. And then as you're not in class anymore and you're doing your homework and your assignments and all that good stuff, I typically allot myself about 2 hours a week, 2 to 3 hours a week per course. So again, another 12 to 15 hours of like homework and assignments. So about 30 hours in total a week of just doing schoolwork and assignments. When I'm not doing school and assignments, I'm working as a Brock ambassador for the university. I'm giving tours to prospective high school or transfer students. So I'm doing that when I'm not doing my schoolwork. I also work at another location on campus as well for another student job. And then when I'm not, you know, working or doing schoolwork, I do like to partake in intramurals as well. So I've been on the ice hockey intramural team. I have done inner tube water polo, which is not as easy as it seems. It gets your arms a little sore. It's quite the workout. But yeah, that's kind of what I like to do in my free time here on campus. And then I've been here for 4 years now. So I've really started to explore the Niagara region as well. So I've been to different wineries in the region. I've been down to Niagara Falls, Niagara on the Lake, and a bunch of different hotspots around St. Catharines, Niagara region.
No, that's great. It sounds like you've really made the most of your 4 years at Brock. But what was your biggest fear coming into university and how did you overcome that?
Yeah. So I had a lot of my high school teachers tell me that in university, you're going to be just a number, your professors won't get to know you. And that was something that I was really fearful of, because I like to ask questions. I'm a very sociable person. I didn't want to be recognized as just a number. But I've overcome that fear in the sense that Brock is the mid-sized campus. So our lectures aren't massive. We don't have thousands of students in one course. So that was a nice factor that I noticed coming into Brock. As well, I really took advantage of seminars that happen after our lectures with teaching assistants. That was a place where I got to know a teaching assistant, other students in my course, and got to ask questions and meet new people. So that really helps overcome that fear of just being a number, fading in a crowd of people. And then also, professors also offer office hours, which I didn't know about coming into university until some of my teaching assistants had mentioned that there are office hours available to go and talk to your professors. So you can go to talk to your professor to introduce yourself, get to know a little bit more about them, ask questions about upcoming assignments or the content that they covered that week. And eventually you go and see them once, twice, a few times a semester, and you actually do get to know your prof, and they do get to know who you are as a person and what kind of student you are. And you aren't just lost in the crowd and you aren't just a number. You actually are a person to your professors as well.
That's great. And I know that's a very relatable fear. So it's really cool to hear you touch on that and talk about it a little bit. But what do you wish someone had told you in high school to prepare for post-secondary?
Yeah, I wish in high school that someone would have told me to get involved as soon as I could on campus. You know, it was a big change living on your own for the first time, meeting new friends, and trying to kind of get situated to life on campus. So I didn't really jump the gun to get involved on campus right away. Now I would consider myself very involved in Brock student life on campus, but in first year I would have liked to have a little nudge to tell me to get out there, go explore the clubs and the groups on campus that Brock has to offer, join some intramural teams right off the bat, and just kind of get involved more on campus, go to those homecoming events, those orientation week events. I didn't attend all of them. I attended some of them, and I still have friends that I made at those events to this day, and they were a great opportunity to meet people, get involved on campus, and really enjoy your life as a Brock student.
Yeah, that makes me miss campus life a lot, talking about all those homecoming events. So what was your favorite course during your time at Brock?
Yeah, so my favorite course at my time at Brock so far has been a third year education course that I've taken. So in this course, we met with a professor in a small room. There's about 20, 25 students, and we really learned what it means to be a teacher. So we were learning about societal factors, cultural factors that may affect our students, and how to overcome these issues we might run into in our classroom. After learning this in the first few weeks of class, we actually got the opportunity to go into a classroom and really start to practice these different techniques that we learned in lecture. So we got to bring them with us, we got to observe students, we got to see, it's called the milieu of the school, and we really got to experience what it was like to be a teacher, the different challenges that may come with being a teacher, and all of that good stuff. So that is definitely by far my favorite course that I've taken so far in university. Another one of my favorite courses, like I mentioned earlier, I am a history student, so I do take quite a few history courses. In my first year of university, I actually took a course called History 1F95, and it is a world history course. And that was really neat for me, because in high school, all I really learned was Canadian history, and then I did take American history, and it was really neat to learn about the history of different countries in the world, different issues that countries have faced, and all of the reasons that they have occurred. So that was one of my favorite courses that I took in my first year and my third year here at Brock.
Oh, those are great. So all our first year students listening to this podcast, they can write down these courses, take in the future. But what are some of the student services you have found most beneficial to you in your time at Brock?
Yeah, so some of the student services that I've used is I've actually used the on-campus doctor's office that we have. So I thought that that was very beneficial as a student. So I have been able to utilize my Brock benefits that I used in first and second year. And I was able to go in there. I was able to meet with a doctor, get prescriptions that I needed, and do any of my doctor's appointments that way. Some other student services that I've used here as a student is A to Z Learning Services. And I always love to tell my first year students who are on tours with me about A to Z Learning Services because I found them very beneficial in my first year of university. I was a little bit worried in high school. We were taught how to write papers in MLA formatting. I didn't really know what a university paper meant when they asked me to write 6 pages about something. I wasn't really sure what 6 pages of information even looked like. But A to Z Learning Services has workshops that you can join. You can sign up or pop in if they have available spaces. And they really taught me how to properly write a paper for a university level of writing. As well, they taught me APA style formatting, which is something that is utilized in pretty much every course here at Brock. So those really helped me set my academic future on the right path here at the university as well.
Yeah, I have to back that APA workshop that saved me in the first year. So that's such a great resource.
Yeah, I recommend.
Yeah, seriously. But for our final question, describe some of the financial supports that you made use of as a student.
Yeah, for sure. So university can seem a little bit daunting. The price of university can be a little daunting for some students. So I always like to mention that OSAP is always something that students can apply for. I've used OSAP every year since I've been a Brock student. So I've applied for OSAP in the summer going into each year, and I'm able to get enough money to help me pay for my tuition, my textbooks, my living costs. So that's something, a financial support that I've utilized as a student as well. Every year, I also take advantage of our One app. So this is an application that all students at Brock can apply for, and it kind of sets you up to apply for all of the scholarships and bursaries that we have here at Brock. So you can use the One app. I've used it. I use it every single summer. As well, we have our external scholarships. So coming into first year, I was awarded a scholarship for my average in high school. So I have used that academic scholarship every year since I've been at Brock, maintaining my average. And then I also have on-campus jobs as well, which helped me with a little bit of extra spending money as a student. You know, so I can go down to Niagara Falls, go to the wineries, hang out with my friends and all that good stuff. So I mentioned previously that I am a Brock tour guide, so I'm a Brock ambassador. So that is one of my on-campus jobs here. And then I also have worked at parking services as well. And that is another on-campus job opportunity that I've utilized as well.
Well, thank you so much for all the information, all the tips and tricks that you've given to our future Badgers. Those are wonderful. We have loved hearing all about your Brock experience today.
Thank you for having me.
Bye, Abby.
Bye.
Thanks for joining us. If you have any questions, you can contact us by email at futurestudent@brocku.ca.